David Bay here. Today we are going to start a new chapter in the system, reproduction, and our chapter is Hormonal and reproduction, module 24. To begin with, we should know the objective of today's class. At the end of this lecture, we should able to describe the components of hypothalamic pituitary gonadal axis, describe what we should able to describe the HPV axis in human male and female. We should be able to understand the feedback regulation of HPV axis, and we should be able to show the synthesis and function of different reproductive units. This first chapter is covered in the following modules: first, hypothalamic pituitary gonadal axis, which includes hypothalamic pituitary testicular axis and hypothalamic pituitary ovarian axis. Next, hormonal feedback regulation of HPV axis, and next, reproductive steroid hormones, its synthesis, mechanism of action, and function. First, introduction. Reproduction is a universal in all living organisms. Reproduction is essential to keep a species alive rather than the organism itself. Human male and female reproductive systems are controlled by hormones released from hypothalamus, anti-reproductory, and gonads. These three structures maintain a hierarchical control on reproductive hormone production and regulate the reproductive homeostasis. These hierarchical axis is called hypothalamic pituitary gonadal axis. Now, what is this axis? The hypothalamus releases gonadal hormone. Hypothalamus is a gonad. Gonad means gonadotropin releasing hormone. So, hypothalamus releases this gonad hormone, which stimulates the synthesis, storage, and secretion of gonadotropin hormone. Gonadotropin hormones are the luteinizing hormone and follicle-stimulating hormone from anterior pituitary gland. These gonadotropin then act on gonads to release reproductive steroid hormones such as testosterone, estrogen, and progesterone, and maintain the reproductive cycle. The axis controlling reproductive function in male is called hypothalamic pituitary testicular axis, and in female is called hypothalamic pituitary ovarian axis. So it is fast in hypothalamus. The hypothalamus secretes gonads, which act on gonads. So the hypothalamus is a small structure present into the brain just below the thalamus. And it measures only 4 centimeters per area and works around 10 grams per year. Despite its small size, it contains many nuclei that are responsible for regulation of erectile function, reproduction, metabolism, temperature regulation, electrolyte imbalance, etc. Now, gonadal hormone is synthesized in hypothalamic neurons, principally located into the arctic nucleus and preoptic area within the hypothalamus. Gonadal hormone from these hypothalamic neurons or areas is released into a portal vessel system, which is called hypothalamic hypophyseal portal vessel, which projects from hypothalamus to anterior pituitary. Now, portal is a vessel that begins and ends with capillaries without going to the heart, which is also this kind of portal system that we can imagine. Through this portal vessel, gonadal hormone enters into the anterior pituitary and acts on pituitary gonadal axis. The pituitary gonadal axis releases FSH and LH in response to gonads. LH and FSH are the primary regulators of gonadal function for reproductive hormone synthesis and gametogenesis. The pituitary gonadal axis contains gonadal receptor and cell surface, B-sensitive, after binding to the DNA, they activate crystallization and IP3-DAG pathway. This results in the synthesis and release of polysensitive hormones from pituitary gonads. In brain, these polysensitive hormones are made to synthesize testosterone, and the opposite, polysensitive hormones and metabolism and synthesize from products essential for spermatogenesis. The industrial source of testes, the loaded cells, and the primary source of testosterone hormone synthesis in polysensitive after releasing some blended cells of embryo-tubulin enters into the bloodstream, into the systemic circulation, and acts on cell surface receptor and the plasma membrane of loaded cell of testes. This is also a G-protein coupled receptor, and binding with LH, it stimulates adenylate cyclase, and activates the protein kinase pathway. This results in modulation of gene transcription and increased synthesis of protein and enzymes important for biosynthesis of testosterone. And loaded cell synthesizes testosterone from testosterone by using multiple enzymes. It is also called steroid hormone biosynthesis. Testosterone is a non-reproductive hormone in men, and SSH hormone acts on the fertility cell present in the follicular tubule of testes. SSH receptor and fertility cell is a G-protein coupled receptor, and binding with SSH it stimulates adenyl cyclase, protein kinase pathway, and increases several protein synthesis. What are these? These are endogenous binding proteins. Binding with SSH leads to synthesis of ADP or the endogenous binding protein. It is situated into the follicular tubule near the development stem. Its main role is to bind with testosterone to keep a high local concentration of testosterone, which is essential for spermatogenesis. Being produced by the fertility cell is adenylate enzyme. It is a type of enzyme which can convert testosterone into estradiol or estrogen, which is important for reproduction. Next is inhibin. A hormone which is also playing an important feedback role in hypothalamic pituitary testes. Next is a growth factor. SSH stimulates production of certain growth factors from certain cells, which is important for spermatogenesis. In humans, what happens? These LH and SSH act on measuring follicular cells and produce steroid hormones, which prevent cholesterol, and also peptide hormones, inhibin and activin. Ovarian follicle contains two important types of cells, theta and gamma cells. Now, theta cell has LH receptor, and gamma cell contains both LH and SSH. These receptors are very G-protein coupled receptors, and binding it stimulates adenylate cyclase, protein kinase A pathway, and increases synthesis of proteins and enzymes important for hormone biosynthesis. For estrogen production, both LH and SSH hormones are required, and the interaction between theta and the gamma cell is essential to carry out all the steps of estrogen hormone biosynthesis. Gamma cell also produces two important peptide hormones, such as inhibin and activin. These peptide hormones are important for feedback regulation of HCG axis. Hormonal feedback regulation of HCG axis. The hypothalamic pituitary testicular axis is under reciprocal inhibition by testosterone and inhibin. Now, this testicular axis is not only generates testosterone and inhibin, but also receives negative feedback action from these genes. Testosterone inhibits the release of generics from hypothalamus and LH secretion from pituitary gland. Inhibin released from the cytosol cell inhibits anterior pituitary gland to release SSH hormone. Next, the hypothalamic pituitary overgrowth. it is responsible for female sex crimes and rape. It observed feedback in relation to digital and economic access. Other symptoms of this problem, first, this problem has a healthy metabolic effect. Second, this problem lowers the blood cholesterol level in the cell. Third, it increases the size and rapid rotation of the body. So, this problem induces the abolition of weight fat in the cell. Fifth, this problem promotes osteoblastic neural growth and inhibit osteoclastic activity. That's why falling menopause when the estrogen levels are very low, which in that falling phase increases the probability of brain fracture due to increased osteoclastic activity and brain function degradation in brain and loss of brain fat. Next, probably is progesterone. Progesterone is a 21 carbon steroid hormone to protect you from the symptom, the symptom, and the symptom, and the symptom, and the symptom. 98% of plasma progesterone is suffering from the symptom with albumin, and the 80% of the symptom is albumin, and the piece is covered by albumin, the human. Only 2% of it is seen in season and after in season. Next, the mechanism of action. The atypical collagen production enters the target cell. That's because it is a lipid soluble and binds to the androgen receptor at the nucleus. The hormone receptor complex then binds to specific hormone response element of DNA and mediates new protein synthesis. Action of progesterone. First is the reproductive function. Action on internal myoglobin is opposite to the effect of estrogen. It reduces the excitability and electrical activity of myoglobin. Progesterone is responsible for endometrial differentiation and cytokine synthesis in male brain cells. So, survival meters become thicker and the brain grows as progesterone. And so, in conjunction with the cell, the modules, the idealizer base are developed in the presence of progesterone. So, it observes feedback regulation in pituitary and hypothalamus by obtaining CDS. Other functions, progesterone increases heat production of the body, which is called basal body temperature, seen just after ovulation. Second, progesterone has respiratory stimulatory action, which is seen during 53 phase of menstruation and during pregnancy. Progesterone promotes child and daughter excretion. Next, it drives the brain factor, the interaction between hypothalamus, pituitary, and gonads maintains the reproductive function. The key hormones that play a role in control of menstrual cycle include somatostatin releasing hormone, GnRH, follicle stimulating hormone, and luteinizing hormone, LH, acetylcholine, LH, and endothelial, estradiol, progesterone, and testosterone hormones. The hypothalamus releases a GnRH hormone, which stimulates the synthesis, the storage, and the secretion of the neurotropic hormones, such as the LH and acetylcholine, from androgen to this. This gonadotropin acts on gonads and release reproductive hormones, such as testosterone, estrogen, and progesterone. And then the reproductive cycle. In male, LH acts on gonadic cell and synthesized testosterone. Testosterone acts on sarcoma cell and synthesized some products, essentially for Thank you.